just seemed to be going so great. I mean, everything was going great, and all of a sudden, I came across a battle in my mind, and the devil began to bring up my past. He began to bring up all kinds of things. Curse words began to come into my mind, and I already stopped cursing, and not cursing, and not cursing again since I've been saved. But the devil was putting all these thoughts in my mind, and I couldn't shake it, I couldn't shake it. I was like, God, I need you. And I went to a revival. A man from North Carolina came to preach. And I went down to the commitment zone. That's what we call the commitment zone. Get down on your prayer bones in the commitment zone. And I went down there. I went down there and I began to pray. But that man didn't know what I was going through. But God knew what I was going through. He came over, he laid his hands on me and began to pray over me. And said, Isaiah 40, verse 31. And I'm getting a little bit ahead of myself, but that's okay. But they that wait upon the Lord.
There's no want, there's no lacking to them that fear him, The young lions do lack and suffer hunger, but they that seek the Lord shall not want any good thing. If you ever feel like you're lacking, it's because you're slacking. And that's the way it's been in my life. There's times I was lacking because I was slacking. Amen. I was slacking. I wasn't praying. I wasn't reading my Bible like I should. But thank God, He revived me. Amen. Yeah. He revived me. He can revive us. How many believe it? He can revive us. Amen. He can cause us to really trust Him and to delight in Him and to commit our ways to Him. And lastly, if we want to eliminate discouragement and have hope and be revived, rest and wait. Psalms 37, verse 7. Rest. I remember going back before I read this verse, where it said, rest in the Lord and wait patiently for Him. And I know a lot of times we don't like to talk about that P word. Amen. But I remember going back to Bible college in 2018, and I was talking to Pastor Kelvin. I said, can I go help somebody? Can I go do this? He said, we'll see. Then I talked to him. Pastor, sir, can I go maybe help somebody start a church? He said, well, brother, one step at a time. And I remember one day, Sister Kelvin may not remember this, but I mean, she came, she put her arms on my shoulder, and she said to me these words, rest. Rest. You know, a little bit I know I needed to rest, and I'm going to get back to this part right here as we bring this to a close, but I needed to rest. I needed to be refreshed. I remember my wife used to tell me before she passed away, don't you think we ought to go back to Bible college? She used to tell me that. Don't you think we ought to go back to Bible college? Because I needed to be refreshed. I needed to be encouraged. I needed to be strengthened. And I needed to be taught again. And we don't like that. Because we think we know it all. Amen? Come on now, somebody, come on. You're afraid to say it. You can say it with me solidly, okay? But the Bible says, rest in the Lord and wait patiently for Him. Rest in the Lord, wait patiently for Him is a command. It's a command. Rest means to cease. It means to be silent to the Lord, to stand still. Take a chill pill, everybody. Let's take a chill pill. It's going to be all right. Amen. So, preacher, I don't like this. That P word. I know I don't like it either. I'm not preaching this tonight because I got it put together, but I need God to help me, to give me grace. I don't pray for patience. I don't say, God, give me patience. Oh, no, I'm not that stupid. But this is the way I do pray, because this is the man. God, give me the grace to do what your word instructs me to do. And it says to rest and wait patiently for the Lord. And listen to this. The Bible says in Lamentations chapter 3, verse 25, the Lord is good unto them that wait for Him. Amen. To the soul that seeketh Him. Amen. This can be painful at times, but it's good for us. I remember being in Macon, Georgia. I was in Macon, Georgia because, you know, Jesus said that you have need of patience. Jesus, why did you put that in there? Jesus, can you not? Please don't put that verse in there. And then James said, oh, you heard of the patience of Job? James, now why did you do that? But I remember being over in Macon, Georgia, maybe about a year ago, a year and a half ago. I was in the hotel and I wanted to change the thermostat. I think it was getting hot and I was trying to get it cool. And so I pushed the button to change it. Nothing was changing. Nothing clicked over. And so I started waiting. I started punching the button. Punching. All of a sudden, this cold came up. Wait! I said, oh, Jesus. Now, I'm not one to go for signs. Amen. I know God can give you a sign here, but even the generation seek for something. But that was absolutely a sign from God, because I've been praying about something. I've been praying, and I'm trying to, you know, you're trying to push God. You know, you're trying to, you know, like, come on, God. When you going to give it to me? God, come on, when you going to do it? Come on. You never been that way? I've been that way. And you're praying, and you're praying. And then all of a sudden, when that cold came up, I said, wait! I was like, oh, God, give me the grace. Give me the grace to wait. Amen. But the Bible says in Psalm 27, check this out. Psalm 27, as we've been ready to bring this to God, wait on the Lord. Wait on the Lord. when